Hey guys, it's Dino.
We are continuing with our series of most instructive games of chess ever played. This is a game 4, and it is pretty exciting and instructive game, to me at least. So I'm excited to show you this game. The winner of this game is a white player, so pay attention to the white moves of white and try to guess the move as in the previous videos. E4. Opens up the pieces and controls the center, fights for the center. E5. And now for these initial moves, you don't have to think much because white can play many moves that are good in this position. So don't try to guess these big moves at the beginning. The next move is F4. This move is really interesting because it sacrifices the pawn to gain control in the center. Because maybe not in the next move, but the white is going to have an opportunity to put two pawns in the center and controls all these critical squares. So it's really interesting opening, and the idea of this move is to sacrifice a pawn to a quick development and control of the center. Now what black didn't take here, instead developed a piece, which is a good move. Putting a piece in the center, control this critical squares, and that's a good move from black side. So pause the video. What would you play for white? The move is knight c6, c3, excuse me. This is good. This is really good move because it develops a piece. Of course, white could have developed knight to f3, but instead, this move is interesting because it is setting up kind of a trap, because it is kind of provoking black to take here, and if he takes, he thinks, and he is actually winning a pawn, but after this move, and maybe queen is going to go back to maybe here, maybe here. Then white can play. Just 1 second. Black can play. G 1 second. Black can play f takes and threaten d4, discover the attack, and this is a really strong center. We have open c file for our rook, and he hasn't developed almost any piece except for the queen. And this is maybe looks kind of weird position, but it is really good because white has a strong center and development, and we are going to castle here, and this is really good compensation for this one pawn. I mean, actually we took back that pawn, so it's even material, and that's it. That's the purpose. Earlier people thought that after this move you are losing a pawn, but it is not really good for black. so that he is essentially just provoking black to take this position. Black didn't play bishop take g1. Instead, he played knight c3, c6, which is good development of a piece. And now, pause the video. Of course, white played knight to f3, developing another piece and also just kind of stopping a threat that was always present. That is actually always present in this opening of this check. Really important move. Now, black played probably, I'm not sure who said it. I think Tarash said it, that this kind of a move is worse than hanging a piece, because it's really, really bad for a few reasons. One, you are moving a pawn instead of developing your pieces. Also, you are just taking a pawn and this pawn doesn't mean anything to you, because probably you're not going to be able to protect it. And also, yeah, probably that's the reason. Also, the reason why is you're wasting your time in general, and you are giving up a center. This pawn from here was controlling this essential squares in the center, and now the next move is really, really obvious for white, and it's really strong, and from there white has an initiative. So pause the video. It's easy to spot actually the next move. That's it. And that it is d4. d4, of course, you're attacking a bishop. He has to move and waste more time, and you are opening up this bishop and attack on this pawn. So this is really, really good now. Bishop before, probably it was better to go back here, and this bishop would be protected, and here it is kind of loose. It is threatening to double up pawn, but if this happens, it's not bad, because this pawn from here is gonna protect this pawn, and probably it can undouble itself by going to c4. Yeah, that's it. So the next move for white is pause the video. Think about it a little bit. It is bishop to f4. Obviously, we don't care about this doubling up a pawn. And now, finally, black played good move, d5, striking in the center, opening up this bishop. What would you do as white? Pause the video. It is e5. This move is not so good, because it has some advantages, but the disadvantages, first let me tell you about disadvantages. You are blocking this bishop, and also you are taking this square for the knight is not available anymore, and those are bad sides. Good side of this move is you are restricting the activity of this knight. He cannot naturally develop at f6. Instead, he has to go to this awkward square and block his own pieces. So essentially, that is it about that move. It has its advantages and disadvantages, and probably it has more disadvantages. So just think about it next time. When we have a position like this, should you push it or just maybe take, or just leave it where it is? Know about these advantages and disadvantages. And now bishop takes c3. He wants to finally double up our pawn, and obviously we are going to take here. Bishop e6. This is not really a good move because bishop should go to the square, or any piece should go to the square where its activity is maximal. So bishop should have gone to this square. This is much, much better diagonal for that bishop. Instead, maybe the purpose of this move is probably just to not allow us to play c4 and undouble our pawn, but it is not really. It is much better here. We are gonna probably get the chance to undouble it, or maybe we don't have to undouble it. It's fine this way. What would you do for white now? Pause the video. Bishop d3, really good move, putting a bishop to its maximum, to the position that exerts maximum power and has a maximal value. And now black played h6. Another bad move. He was afraid of knight going here or here, but of course we're not gonna play that move. Instead, we are going to develop our pieces and then attack. So that is unnecessary move. Also, again, he's moving a pawn instead of developing a piece and finishing up a development. So, and of course, he's moving pawns that are gonna be probably in front of a king when he castles here. So another weakening of a pawn structure. And beginners do that all the time. And now knowing this, we should be able to punish it, or try to punish the bad positional play. Pause the video. What's the next move? The next move is of course castling. Now this rook is blocked by his pieces right now, but these pieces are not pawns, they are pieces and they are gonna move, and this pressure is gonna be fatal. And of course we are putting our king into safety at the corner of the board. Knight g2 e7. It's the only square for the knight to develop, so it is awkward, but It is what it is. And now pause the video. The next move is Rook to B1. Now, beginner would say that why play this move? Why not just start an attack here because you have your pieces here and proceed? But master or expert would without any thought play this move because rooks belong on open file. Always try to put your pieces at the best positions, and rook is the best positioned at the open file, and also he's threatening to take this pawn. So of course when playing a move that is threatening something or attacking something is always good and positive. Well, black played b6, which is another bad move because it weakens the light squares. Also, this pawn was defending the knight, and maybe this knight it is more loose. And of course, you are just changing your pawn structure and not thinking a lot about it. So it is. Is not good because you are weakening your structure. Instead, masters would play maybe try to play maybe rook to b8, not trying to change your structure, pawn structure, or maybe queen to c8 instead, and not hurrying up with move like b6. And now, what do you think the move is? Pause the video. It is a wonderful move, queen to d2. I really like this move because it is kind of a quiet move and it seems like it does nothing, but actually you finished with this move for development. You connected your rooks, and then these rooks are gonna be, they're free to move as they wish at their back rank. They can double up on any file they wish, and it is so good. This position is, I really like this position. These bishops are pointed toward this king side, and it is, everything is just going in a good way. Now, black castled, and really bad move because you probably should have tried to do something else, not castle, because all white pieces are in this direction, pointed in this direction, and it is really conducive disposition for kingside attack, and it's really dangerous for black to castle here. And as you are going to see how powerful a white attack is, because all these factors, all these positional advantages that he has. So now pause the video. Critical move in this position. It is bishop takes h6. Let's see why bishop h6 takes, and of course we are going to take. This move is really good because for a few reasons. First of all, we have our queen here, really powerful piece that is just next to the king, really close to the king, and really dangerous for black here. Checkmate is near. Also, we gave our bishop and took two pawns, which is approximately the same. Three pawns are the value of bishop, but we took critical pawns that are in front of a king, and that are shelter for the king, and they are gone now. Also, we are threatening checkmate with this move, or actually we are threatening now checkmate. And we also, when we go here, our rook can go here and here, and this is really, really dangerous for black. Black tried knight g6, probably the only move, because any other move like this pause the video and try to see what would happen after this. We're gonna take, and we're gonna take this knight. On bishop f5, the same story, we're gonna take and take the knight. You see now, this move played a crucial difference, because this piece is unprotected, and tactics work great here. Any other move is losing now, so we're not gonna comment a lot about them. So knight g6, and now pause the video. The next move is knight to g5, threatening checkmate on h7. Probably the only move that black can play is rook to e8, making a room for the king. But now, what? Pause the video. There's a few ways to finish this game, and the man who played this game wanted to checkmate the opponent with this move, rook to f7, and now after taking, pause the video. Probably you see now this really clearly, queen to h7, and queen f7, checkmate. Let's go back and summarize. Purpose of this move, as I said, to remove this pawn and try to put d4 pawn in the center and control the central squares. Development of peace. Really bad move, as it allows this, what we wanted. This move, I told you, has advantages and disadvantages. Disadvantages blocks these bishops, and also is taking a square that can be used by our knight. But advantages, it restricts the activity of this knight. Bishop should have been developed here to a better diagonal. We have done that. Weakening of a king side, and also not developing peace. Putting our bishop on the open file and attacking. weakening light squares. Quiet move, but really powerful. Putting our queen at a good diagonal and connecting our rooks. This move is walking into the sacrifice, and the game is going to be finished real soon. Now it's really easy to play. I hope you liked this game. I enjoyed in it very much. So thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe if you want to see more videos, and see you in the next video.